Well, hello everybody, it's Shawn Petite back for part three and the final part of creating with Yupo. So I'm bringing back some of the pieces that I created earlier, and again, these have sat for a while, but until you've sealed them, you can continue to manipulate and take off any paint or areas with alcohol, and that's what I'm doing. I'm feeling like this needs to be lightened up and add some interest, and so I'm just, with my paper towel and some alcohol, lifting up parts and pieces. And I'm using a Donna Downey stencil, and then this stencil is my stencil, it's In the Garden stencil. All of the supplies that I use today will be listed on Donna Downey's blog and links as well. So I'm going to be taking this large piece of Yupo and cutting it down and mounting it onto some MDF panels. And so I laid them out to kind of get an idea if I had enough interest in all areas. And I felt like I needed to add a few more spots. And then once I took that paint up, I didn't want it to be super stark white. So I just add a little bit of color back in. And I'm using quinacridone magenta quinacridone nickel azole gold. Spraying some alcohol on there to get some of those yummy spots and drips and things that happen naturally with alcohol. And I wanted just to add just a few bright touches here and there, so I just added some fluid, and I'm using fluid acrylic on all of my projects, so I just added some on a paper towel and then touched in some areas. Now I wanted to show you too that you can, with a Q-tip or a paintbrush, go back in and take off specific areas or draw into your Yupo before it's sealed still. And so I'm just highlighting a couple of areas on the petals, not the whole thing, just adding some interest here and there. And I just saturate my Q-tip and go in and just kind of scrub. And here I'm just kind of giving you an idea of how you can draw into the Yupo that you've created, the creation that you've created already. Now I've got a paintbrush. Really, there's just so many fun options that you can do with this Yupo. Now that I love how it looks, I'm going to go ahead and seal it like I have in my previous pieces. I'm going to give it two coats of fluid matte medium to keep everything in its place. Then I'm going to cut, and I'm not a measurer, but you can measure. I just eyeballed out the pieces and cut them to size. And now I will mount them onto my wood using golden gel, the heavy gel. It works really well to hold everything in place. And what's really great about the Yupo is there's no buckling, no bubbles. It's seamless when you put it down onto a substrate. Now I'm tidying up the edges, any unstraight lines or different things like that, and just kind of filling in, giving it a real painterly look around my edges. And then I'm also going to go around some of the edges with some charcoal because that is my signature. So let's move on to the next project. So this piece here, when I first did it, I didn't like it at all, and I told you that I would leave it because we can always, always make it great again with Yupo. So I'm going through the same process of just lifting the paint with alcohol until I find a design that I really like, because we're going to make this into a card. Now I'm coming back in with just a paper towel and some alcohol, and I'm lightening up the edges and kind of revealing what's underneath a little bit, but not too much. Now I'm going to take my golden gel medium, matte gel medium, and I'm laying down a piece of vintage paper, and I'll brayer that out so I get it nice and flat. And I want to take just a little bit of fluid, high flow acrylic, and kind of knock down that script that's on there so that I've got a good place for writing for my card. Now that I've got that all down, I want to seal everything, the front and the back. And I've folded it, and now I want to kind of highlight some areas so that the yummy goodness that I'm going to put on with some collage elements will really stand out and pop. Dripping some drips with the high flow is a wonderful experience. I just love it. It works so well. And it needed just a tad bit of color for contrast. Now I want to just take some of those drips and just edge the inside of the cards to kind of bring it all together. Real randomly. I'm going to be putting all of my collage elements down with, again, golden gel medium. It's such a versatile medium. You can use it for so many things. A lot of these collage elements are available in my shop or free on my website, so you can check that out. And I've used one of Donna Downey's Itty Bitty stamps, which I am just loving. And I just stamped it onto a scratch piece of paper. And then I cut out those words and placed them down. I had to kind of pick them up and place them down again to get them all to fit and work, but I like how it turned out. And I'm just shading around my elements to give it a finished look. And then I will edge it with some archival ink pad in black, and we will call her done. Spray it with a fixative because you've used charcoal. That's what I'm doing now. That's Spectrafix, and it's available in Donna Downey's shop. Now those leftover bits that I have from the first project of me putting all of those squares down onto my wood, these are the leftovers. And we're going to make some tags, and I'm just putting it down on, again, some vintage looking paper with my gel medium. and cutting those out to look like tags. And now let's embellish them. So I'm using another one of Donna Downey's stencils. And again, those will be listed on the blog. I'm also using one of my stencils. It is Garden 2. And some modeling paste. I'm using a little bit of modeling paste, Golden's modeling paste. And I'm using a gel pen now to kind of outline those stenciled areas. It's kind of hard to see in the video, but they show up really well and it's highlighting that black so that they don't just disappear into that tag. So now that I've done that, I've just printed out on regular copy paper some words, sentiments that I would like to see on my tags. And I'm using some golden matte gel again and the sepia high flow color, and I'm putting those words down. And it acts as a glue sealer, and it has that sepia color so that it looks aged and yummy and vintage. And I'm also going to use it over that area that's raised with the modeling paste to just give it that aged look too. Adding some signature charcoal pencil marks. And then I will edge these again with some archival ink stamp pad in black. I added various ribbons, and look at how cute. Again, I did spray those with Spectrafix because I used charcoal. And this little piece that we did on our first time around, I loved it so much that I didn't want to do anything with it. So I'm just showing you that I probably will frame it. So here are our projects, and I thank you so much for joining me today, and next week we will have brand new goodies to play with. If you liked today, give me a like and subscribe, and I will see you next week.